Dancing culture, as I said, after the fall of the Roman Empire, when things were completely different, as a termine, which were no longer used, they are not in existence. Instead of that, so-called bathhouses, bathhouses were established. But you can see also on that pic that the bathing was in a closed bathing tub without any steam and no flowing water. You can see that cupping was performed in smaller also Germans were always very fond of bathing in the rivers and in the seas. And from the 19th century on, Russian steam baths became very famous, and also sauna were used, and still Germans are very favorable, as I said, to bathing. Okay, we have three kinds of new opportunities. Well, the first is global tourism, second is global migration, and the third is global wellness trends. What do I mean with this? First point, oops, Germans and tourism. In 2019, the Germans and Germany became world tourism champion again. It means that more than 61% of the German population made at least one holiday trip lasting more than 5 days. And more than 40% of the Germans make at least 2 holiday trips a year. The most important increase of travelers is age 25 plus. And all in all, the 75 billion euros spent on traveling, and this sums, as a North Indian, I don't know how much it is in black and crow, but I wanted to present this to you. Okay. This means the Germans in general are very favorable. People are willing to travel, even long distances, and to pay huge amounts of money, but it has to be guaranteed that they have a special event, something special there, experience. Yeah. So this is they want Germans are always concerned about money. They want to have something for their money. So I'm asking, what makes especially the Hammam interesting? So here in this slide, which I hopefully have, I'm asking what makes the Hammam interesting. First thing is around the Hammam, the European people have a concept of a certain kind of exoticism, of also a kind of orientalism, something they are interesting. They have the concept of the harem, also, which is also in paintings, in the European paintings from the 19th century. And this is very, it has to be kept in mind. It has to be a little exotic. Then the second thing is that the Hammams have an interesting history. They are rooted in history, in something historic is interesting. Third point, the marble floors and the central massage platforms are very interesting for people, all this marble, all these things. Next point, the traditional clothes, all the towels, all the traditional ones, in Arabic futa, Tunisian, originally Tunisian, the clothing, Hammam clothing, all the accessories there in the Hammam are interesting to people, appealing to people, and to have the tea, oriented tea after all the things is also interesting, and not to forget to have a massage from somebody is also very appealing to people. So as I also said, you see this aspect I want to show of orientalism in Western culture. It is reflected in paintings like this. All this hammami is something very exotic, even like linked to erotic in some point, but it's, you cannot forget. But not to forget, the Hammam has of course made some important effects, which I already have shown. I think I must not talk about this pain relief and slight increase in something with temperature, slight increase in heart rate, and all in all, and most important, the psychological well-being of the bugs. Okay, this is was the first point, the tourism aspect, and the other aspect. Second is, and this cannot be underestimated in the West, the global migration. In Germany, the Muslim population is now between 4.4 and 4.7 million people. It means 5.4% of the German population, which is around between 81 and 82 million. And we have, as many of you have heard, all these refugees during the last years, most of them are also Muslims. All these Muslim people have knowledge about the Hammam and might have used it also either in their country or during their holidays in their home countries. Germans also know about hammaming as well. So it is important to say that even in Germany, with all this Muslim population, we have hammams. They have been established during the last years. These are the things, the events, or even these are bathing events, where people go to the hammam. Turkish people go to the hammams before the marriage, after giving birth, or the child has to be in the hammam 40 days after birth, and the child has to be taken to the hammam before circumcision. So this led to establishment of a hammam in almost every German city. So okay. This is an example of the city of Düsseldorf. The city is very beautiful, and it is not only, of course, for the Turkish community, but also Germans love to go. Foreign people to us, we have this sauna process. So For most people, it is no problem, the question of nudity. So if they are confronted with the Hammam, so what will happen to the question? Second, third one is the question of gender segregation. So in Germany, some Hammams often offer days for women only or for men only, but Germans, of course, when they are on holiday, they want to go with their whole family. So what would be the question if you come with the whole family? And if my husband has to leave, has to stay outside, or my children are not allowed. So this would be an obstacle which has to be kept in mind and has to be organized. Finishing my presentation, I want to say how it should not be made, even keeping up these experiences, because in 1993, I think, I traveled to Syria 6 weeks and I stayed in Damascus, and one day our group of students, all of us Germans, wanted to go to the Hammam because it was very hot in Damascus. Almost 40 degrees, and Hammam would be very relieving for us to handle the heat. But the problem was it was Women's Day. So all men of our groups had to stay outside, go home. Okay. First thing. Then we came inside, and it was quite unclean. So waste lying on the floor, not very nice. The Hammam itself is one of the oldest Hammams in Damascus, which is not, it was okay for us because we didn't expect such a pretty thing like the one in Brazil. But then also, there was a disagreement with the person who had a massage, gave us a massage, because German, for example, do not remove as oriented people. The hair of the neck, and they were very, she was saying, oh, then I have to give you an extra massage, and she was rubbing us very strongly, and so it was, and she was very harsh to us only because of our body hair, yeah? So what I wanted to say, finally, and this is my conclusion, if you want to win people for the Hammam, you always have to have a look on these cultural expectations. You have to handle that. On the other hand, I think you have to create a real brand, Yonami Hammam. Of course, the Germans know about Ayurveda. Many of us have